Hello all, my name is Elliot Boyd and I'm an Energy Services Advisor here at Competitive Energy Services. And in today's video, we're going to be reviewing how the ISO New England capacity market works and the actions that you can take to manage your electricity costs and make the market work for you. So our presentation today is going to cover the basics of peak day and how capacity charges work here in New England. And we'll kick things off with peak day 101. And then we'll review historical peak loads. And we'll walk through what CES is expecting for summer 2021. Specifically, we'll cover the impacts of the coronavirus pandemic, New England solar development, and some of the ways we're thinking about peak day for the summer of 2021. And lastly, we'll review CES self-help and how reacting to peak events could impact your bottom line. So we'll kick things off with peak day 101. And we should start things by introducing you to ISO New England, our independent system operator here for the New England region. And ISO New England does a few things. They oversee grid operations, they administer wholesale energy markets, and importantly for our purposes today, they conduct long-term power system planning. So in short, ISO New England ensures that everyone here across the region has the electricity that they need when they need it. So next, let's walk through some of the key terms we'll be using today. The first of which is capacity. And the capacity is the ability to make energy and put it on the grid at any given time. And most days throughout the year, ISO New England has enough capacity to meet the demand on the grid without any issues. But there are a handful of days, particularly during the summer, when ISO New England needs to call on additional generation to meet the demand on the grid. And we call these peak days. And having that capacity to meet demand on those peak days is necessary for a reliable grid. The next term we want to define is the forward capacity market. And this is the forecasting and auction process that ISO New England uses to contract with generators and really to make sure that the grid has the capacity it needs from year to year. In other words, this is how ISO New England charges electricity users for capacity. And for the purpose of our presentation today, we need to know that each end user pays into this forward capacity market because it funds investments which are, quite frankly, necessary for grid reliability. So how are your capacity charges determined? Well, you're going to pay for your share of capacity costs based off of the capacity tag for each of your utility accounts. And utilities set the capacity tags based off of the amount of electricity that each account is using during the annual system peak, or the single hour in the year when the demand for power is at its greatest. So there is a calculation that you can use to determine your capacity costs, but if you're interested in learning more about the capacity costs at your facility, we would encourage you to reach out to our team, and we'd be happy to discuss this formula in further detail. So it's important to know that not all electricity users can manage their capacity costs, rather. Only accounts with interval meters, otherwise known as telemeters, can manage their capacity tag. So why does this matter? Well, for electricity users with telemeters, the peak day of the year presents an opportunity to curtail electricity usage, lower your capacity tag, and reduce total electricity costs. So next, let's take a look at how grid demand has changed over the past 15 years. And we'll start things off with this ISO New England annual system peak graph. And over the past 15 years, the key indicators which suggest a system peak could occur have remained largely the same. So extended heat waves and high industrial load are two key pieces of the equation. Now, the air conditioning demand across commercial, industrial, and residential facilities, it ramps up each summer in response to the hotter temperatures. And as a result, ISO New England anticipates more demand for electricity. The graph here, we're showing on the y-axis, the total megawatt demand on the grid. And on the x-axis, we're looking at the year, month, and date where the peak day occurred each year. So you can see based on this graph that the system peak for each year dating back to 2006 occurred between June and August on a day when temperatures rose into or above the high 80s. And over the past 5 years, the peak system demand has been roughly between 23,000 and 26,000 megawatts. So if our goal is to reduce electricity demand on the peak day, we want to focus our curtailment efforts on the peak hour, which is defined as the specific hour when the grid demand is at its highest, which is the hour which is going to be used to determine your capacity tag and later your capacity costs. So this graph is showing a daily demand curve over the past 6 years, with the y-axis highlighting demand in megawatts and the x-axis representing the time of day. And you'll notice that the peak hour for each summer since 2017 has occurred between 4 and 6 p.m. And looking at these trends can help us to anticipate what to expect for the summer of 2021. Another note, the table at the bottom of your screen showing the day that the system peak occurred. So our peak in 2020 occurred on July 27th, which happened to be within 3 days of 2019 system peak of July 30th. But as we look further back in time, we can see that the peak day can fall anywhere between late May through early September. And this really adds to the difficulty of predicting the peak hour for 2021. And that all leads to the question, well, what can we expect for summer 2021? First things first, we could take a look at how COVID-19 has impacted daily electricity load for New England. And this graph is going to show us the daily peak demand for 2019 in blue, 2020 in yellow, and 2021 in red. And you can see we only have data up through May 1st for 2021, based off of what's available at the moment. But as we look back and we look for trends, what we see is that the initial lockdowns that occurred in March of 2020 when the pandemic hit reduced total daily demand by about 3 to 5%. But as we moved later into the summer and you look at this gold line, you can see that the 2020 daily peak load began to return to 2019 levels and even surpassed it at times. And this year, as we move into this warmer spring months, we're still seeing some curtailed demand across specific sectors, but residential electricity demand remains high as many workers continue to work from home. And some manufacturers and commercial operators are increasing production and output, but we've also seen others decline. So as the economy looks to recover from the pandemic, we are in fairly uncharted territory. But the best that we can do here is to use last year as a proxy for electricity demand through economic uncertainty. And what we saw last year was a demand profile similar to previous years, with peaks driven largely by stretches of hot and humid weather. Another major factor in predicting the peak day, specifically the peak hour, is the expansion of solar resources coming online in New England. Specifically, the impact is a result of the behind-the-meter solar systems, which serve to reduce load on the grid by generating and supplying electricity directly to users. And this graph from ISO New England shows a daily demand curve, which highlights the reduction that results from solar photovoltaic systems. Now, the x-axis shows the hour of the day, and the y-axis here shows us demand on the grid once more. And the dashed orange line coming across the middle here is highlighting the estimated demand that's being reduced by the behind-the-meter solar systems here in New England. So you can see that without that solar production, we would expect that peak hour or the highest point on this demand curve to fall even earlier in the day. And the takeaway is that solar is shifting that peak grid demand to later in the day. In fact, that 5 to 6 p.m. peak hour that we saw for both 2019 and 2020 is the latest peak hour we've seen on record over the past 20 years. And as more solar comes online, we can expect this trend to continue. So what does this all mean for predicting peak day in 2021? Well, knowing and understanding the factors is important, but predicting the peak day and specifically the peak hour, it's not an exact science. So we can expect the peak day to fall in the evening, sometime between June and August, But there's a whole bucket of variables that make the peak day hard to predict. The first of which is the production and activity of solar, which is largely determined by cloud cover. Another factor is the day of the week, which impacts industrial electricity demand. And lastly, both temperature and humidity, which drive demand for air conditioning load across the Northeast. So all these competing variables raise the question, well, how is a commercial energy customer supposed to account for all these factors and plan to respond to a peak event? And that's where CES comes in. So in this last section, I'll cover CES self-help, which is one easy way to manage your capacity costs. So CES self-help is an exclusive service offered to CES clients, whereby we provide regular information and action alert emails to notify customers when a possible peak event is on the horizon. We'll provide detailed guidance on the likelihood of a peak event, outlining all the contributing factors. This slide is a sample of the messaging that we provide between 6 and 12 times a year, depending on the weather and the factors at play. So before we go, let's take a look at an example from a CES customer. So this graph shows the daily load curve of a CES self-help customer who was able to curtail their electricity usage during the peak hour for 2019. So the daily load curve is similar to those we've seen on other slides today, with the x-axis showing the hour and the y-axis showing demand. And each line is representing a specific day of the week. So the dotted red line here shows the customer's load profile on a normal summer day when no curtailment action was taken. And the solid red line showing usage curtailment response, which was taken by this customer between 4 and 6 p.m. during that peak hour following one of CES's notifications. That red circle that you see indicates the hour in which the customer's capacity tag was determined. And you can see that this customer reduced their demand on the grid by roughly 60% for this electricity account during this event. So this graph is meant to highlight how much an end user can reduce their demand and impact their capacity tag. These curtailment efforts saved a customer roughly $270,000 on their annual electricity costs. And that's how the CES self-help program works. We help our clients to plan and prepare for these events through a system of detailed notifications. So here are some key takeaways from our presentation today. First, capacity is an important part of your electricity bill. And uniquely, it's one that you have the power to control. If you have a telemeter and you have the ability to curtail electricity during a peak demand event. And the second, the peak day is hard to predict due to the many factors which determine when the peak day will occur, that bucket of variables we talked about. And third, CES can help. We have the resources and expertise to help you anticipate and respond to a peak demand event. So we'd like to thank you for joining us today and welcome you to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on social media for more CES University resources and other market notifications. Again, my name is Elliot Boyd, and if you have any questions or comments about this presentation, feel free to reach out to me directly. Stay safe and have a great summer.